All right, we're going to talk about branching and merging and some different workflows that you might use in Git along with GitHub. So I've got this real small repository on GitHub that I called Merge Examples, and really it's only got one kind of interesting file, and that's this little bit of C code that we've seen in other videos. Now this C code wouldn't actually compile; it has some problems with it. So we're going to make some corrections to those. We're going to use a workflow where instead of working in our master branch, we're actually going to create a new branch and make those changes in a different branch and then merge them. So what we can do is go back to Cloud 9. Here, clearly, we're in our repo. We're going to create a new branch, and we're going to do it in one step where we're going to create the branch and also check it out immediately. So we're going to say git checkout dash b for branch, and then we'll call the new branch, say bug fix one, because we're going to pretend like we're fixing bugs in our C code there. So you can see that here the branch name has changed from master to bug fix one on the command line. So what we'll do is we'll go ahead and make some changes then to file 1.c. Just like if you've seen the tutorial on Vim, you saw that we made some changes to this file. I'm not going to make all the same changes that we made before, but we'll make a few of the same. We'll stop there, and we'll go ahead and write and quit this file, and we'll go ahead and make a commit now. So we'll commit this change, give it a commit message, fix typos, and of course, if we look at what's in file one, of course, you can see what's the file after we've made the changes. Now we can go back to master, and we can see what's in file one now on master. Our file, and you see that it has the unchanged version. So we're going to assume that we've tested bug fix one, and we want to now merge those changes back into master. And so what we can do is actually just do git merge. Master bug fix one, and now if we look at what's in file 1.c, you see those corrections are made, and so now master and bug fix one branches are the same, and we could go ahead and say delete bug fix one branch with the command git branch capital D bug fix one, and so now if we just type git branch, you see that we're back to just one branch, that is master. So this is a typical workflow where you typically, or one workflow is to not do really any work in master itself, but rather to create branches, make the fixes in those branches, or new features or whatever, in the branches, and then once you've tested the code and it's complete, you know it's working, then you can merge it back in. So. Actually, what we'll do next is we'll look at a workflow where we're going to use GitHub for some of this as well. So we want to make a few more changes to the file there. So what we'll do this time, we'll say git checkout dash branch hotfix, just to give it a different name. So now we're in the branch hotfix. We'll open up the file there. And we'll make some changes. For example, we want to change int to void. And we'll go ahead and write quick, and we're going to make a commit. And we're going to say, change int to void. And then we're going to keep working. So that was just one incremental commit. We're going to keep working on our file. In this case, we'll do something like this, and again, make another commit locally. So we'll do git commit, and in this case, We'll say, you know, hotfix complete. Okay. So then we'll check out master again. So then we'll check out master again. This time what we want to do is we have those two commits in there, and what we really want to care about, we don't care about the incremental commit where we changed into void. We want the total sort of complete hotfix complete commit to be the final commit. And if we look at the commit history, if we look, you know, here, we don't want to clutter up our history with all these sort of incremental commits that aren't important. So what we can do is we can do git merge squash master hotfix. And so that merged it, but not only did it merge it, but it so if we look at what's in file C, you see that things have been fixed, things have been updated here, but the git log, it doesn't show those incremental commits. So what we'll have to actually do is do one more commit, right? So we'll one more incremental commit here, squash merge from hotfix. Sorry, this is not an incremental commit, but rather this is the commit that's going to show up in the log. So now that we have a clean log, it doesn't show those incremental commits, and then we could push this back to GitHub. So git push. And so if we go over here and do a refresh, we'll see that those changes have been made. Okay, but there's one more workflow I'll just show you. I think I mentioned this before and started it, but then I wanted to show you the squash merge, so I got sidetracked. But we can actually utilize GitHub's, we can utilize GitHub in the workflow itself. So what we'll do here, let's type git branch to see our branches. We have the hotfix branch there. So what we'll do is we'll go ahead and check out hotfix, and we'll continue some work here. So let's just do something easy. Let's just say change the name of this from quit to complete, or something like that. So then what we can do is we can go ahead and commit this. And we can push this to GitHub. So we can say git push. In this case, it's still going to be origin, but instead of the branch master, we want to push hotfix itself. And so then if we do that, if we go back over here, go back to the home directory, you see that the merge is here. You see the additional branch. If you click on the branches, there is a branch hotfix. You can see that there's a file there that we've changed to complete. Going back to the main, also, there's this big yellow bar here that says hotfix has been, there's been a branch hotfix that's been pushed less than a minute ago. And so what we can actually do is then type compare and pull request. So we can use the features of GitHub that would allow us to compare the two branches. So in this case, our master branch has this line quit, and the new branch has this new line complete. And so it does tell us that we can't automatically merge this. So we can still create a pull request, but we'd have to do the merge back locally on our machine. In this case, this is not a big deal. What we're going to do is we'll just go ahead and create the pull request. It says the branch has conflicts that must be resolved. You can look here. We can actually do some editing in this interface itself. So, for example, if we wanted to keep the change there, we could delete those lines. We can mark this as resolved, and then we can do commit merge. And this now this pull request has no conflicts with the base branch, so we can merge the pull request, confirm the merge, and then even delete the branch if you'd like to. And so then going back here, if we look at what's on master, this has all been changed for us. So this would typically be done in a team atmosphere. So you know, usually one team member would create a branch and submit a pull request, and then somebody would code review that and fix any conflicts if necessary, and then merge it in if that's what they wanted to do. Of course, if we go back to Cloud9, go back to our master branch. And look at look at the file. Well, the change hasn't been made here because this is our local branch. So what we need to do is then do a git pull, and then if we look at the file now that we've pulled down the changes from GitHub, the quit has been changed to complete, and we're all the same as we were on master. So that's some advanced workflows with branching and merging and using GitHub and pull requests.